Hey guys, it's Kels here today. So you know on my channel we've been talking about reverse culture shock and the difference between living here in the States and living overseas in Europe. Today I am going to talk about the question that has been on everybody's minds. How exactly do you move overseas? I have 7 ways you can do that, and if you're interested, keep watching. One that you can live overseas, you can go there to study. That is the way that I did it. I decided that I needed to study for my master's, and the one thing I didn't do undergrad that I kind of regretted was not studying abroad. So I looked into programs for my master's, my MBA degree abroad, and found the perfect program for me overseas, and I was able to get financing to do so because it was an accredited program. So if you want to get your master's or even your undergrad degree, kind of like there's a YouTuber here, Tia Taylor, I'll link her channel below. She's studying at Bocconi right now in Italy, in Milan. She's doing her undergrad. I did my master's. So if you want to study or live overseas, totally a possibility for you. Number 2, find an international job. You can do this 2 ways. One, you can look directly for international jobs online. There are a bunch of them, but you have to remember that you are going to need to be sponsored for a visa, depending on the country that you're going to. And if you are in a specialist career, it might be easier for you. But if you're in a more generalist position, it might be a little bit harder, because one of the qualifications to work overseas is that, to get the visa to work overseas, is that they can't find anyone in their own country who can fill the position. So if you have a PhD or a very unique skill or craft that they need in the country that you want to go to and they can't find in their home populace, then you might be in good luck to get a job, an international job directly. The third way you can do it, still getting an international job, is to be seconded there. So if you work at a multinational company here in the States and they have offices, say, in London, after you've worked for the company for about a year, you can put in for a transfer. Depends on the company, but the companies I know of, it's about a year, you can put in for an international transfer. Obviously, you have to bring a lot of value to the company, you have to know the right folks, but that is the third option you can use to go and live overseas. The fourth option that I know people do is they become an au pair. An au pair is like a bit of a nanny. It's A-U-P-A-I-R. And a bunch of my European friends actually use this to travel to other international countries. And some of them use it to come to the United States. So just Google that. And essentially, you become kind of a live-in caretaker for a kind of a wealthy-ish family's children. Some will argue that the family won't be that wealthy, but you know, if you can imagine someone who needs, who can pay, afford to have someone stay with them and take care of their children, probably have a little bit of a pretty penny or whatever. So that is your fourth way you could live overseas. Your fifth way is Job Corps. So you might not be living in the most luxurious countries overseas, but it is definitely a way to get overseas and international exposure if you join a government, a U.S. governmental program such as Job Corps, where you're going to do service to other countries through this program. So look into it, Google that, Job Corps. Your sixth way is to teach. I know a couple of friends that went to Korea, I believe, and China. I'm not sure if China, it might have been another country where they went to go and teach English. So if you can look for, Japan. If you can look for accredited programs where if you're a native English speaker, you can go over to these countries and teach English. Granted, it is a very competitive program. You have to find the right programs for you. You can't just not do your research. All of these tips come with doing your research. So, but teaching English is an opportunity for you to sign up for the, do your research, find up for the correct program, and potentially go overseas to live for a while and teach English to students wanting to learn American English. And your final way that you can live overseas is you can just travel. So for instance, going to London, you can go to London and stay for 6 months. Granted, you cannot work there, but you can, as an American, go over to London and stay and kind of gallivant, have a good time for up to 6 months on the, and you don't without a visa as an American. So if you're interested just doing a kind of a short-term stint without having to study or without having to work or without having to be kind of an au pair or anything like that mentioned previously in this video, you can just go and do an extended vacation there and take some time off of work or work remotely on American clients. I believe that's okay, from Specifically, I'm speaking about London in this instance because that's the one I know. So those are your seven ways you can live, travel overseas longer term. I know you guys were like blowing up my inbox asking me, how do I live overseas? Those are the seven tips that I have for you. If you know any other ways that you can live overseas other than like marrying somebody, you can also apply directly to the country, but that's a little bit difficult right now. So that will probably be your eighth way. But if you guys know any other ways to move overseas, please leave them in the comments below. There's a bunch of people who, because of our conversations about reverse culture shock, are really down for the cause of moving overseas, and I cannot fault you because I'm really still considering if I want to make that big leap permanently or at least, you know, for an extended period of time. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and I appreciate you guys and all the conversations we had around the reverse culture shock phenomenon or, you know, experience. Leave your comments and anything below, and I will see you guys again in my next one. Bye.